Hey everybody, welcome to Dog Oracle. Today, we are going to go over the differences between a Border Collie and an Australian Shepherd. Make sure to watch until the end of the video to fully differentiate the two confusing breeds. Before we get into the video, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell to get notified when we release more amazing dog videos like this one. History. For the common folk, the Border Collie and the Australian Shepherd may look identical, and since they are both great herding dogs, they may have come from the same breed. But despite the similarities, numerous differences can be seen to set the two breeds apart. One of the best ways to differentiate the two is through the history of their breeds. Australian Shepherd. Australian Shepherds have a perplexing history and are often debated by dog historians. The widely accepted history of the breed is that their ancestors originated from the Scottish Highlands and the Pyrenees Mountains in Spain, whose shepherds traveled all the way to Australia to look for better patches of land. These travelers then found that they could not farm the way they wanted since the landscape in Australia is highly arid, and so, together with other shepherd dogs, moved out of Australia and sailed all the way to North America. Upon reaching the North American continent, these travelers continued breeding the shepherd dogs that they brought from Australia until they were able to perfect the breed. It was then that they named the breed Australian Shepherd. However, the dog became more American rather than Australian. The Australian Shepherd breed has been used to herd livestock such as cattle and sheep, along with their cowboy partners. Despite being a herding dog, the Australian Shepherd became popular as a family dog and was ranked 17th by the American Kennel Club in their most popular breed ranking. Border Collie. Border Collies, on the other hand, have a much simpler history compared to the Australian Shepherd. The Border Collie was created by crossing the large herding dogs of the Romans with that of the Icelandic sheepdog, the herding dogs of the Vikings. This happened after the Vikings' invasion of Rome, a short time after the Romans invaded Britain. The breed has persisted until this very day and is ranked as one of the most intelligent breeds worldwide. The Border Collie has also been ranked as the 35th most famous dog breed in the USA by the American Kennel Club. The breed nowadays is often crossed with other breeds due to their good nature, creating the so-called designer dogs such as the Collar Chider, a mix between a Border Collie and a Chihuahua, and a Borador, a mix between a Border Collie and a Labrador Retriever. Appearance. Border Collies and Australian Shepherds look very similar to each other, and it is speculated that Australian Shepherds were bred from a Border Collie years ago. However, there is no solid evidence to this, and we can only speculate. With that, here are some of the differences between the Australian Shepherd and the Border Collie in terms of appearance. The coat of an Australian Shepherd is bilayered, which means there's an overcoat and an undercoat to protect the dog from harsh weather conditions. Overall, the coat of an Australian Shepherd can be long and dense. Their tails are long, but some Australian Shepherds are born with bobtails. Their eyes have a condition called heterochromia, where one eye has a different color than the other. It can't be stressed enough that the Border Collie looks the same as the Australian Shepherd. However, their main difference lies in their coat length and tail shape. Border Collies also have bilayer coats, but comparing it to the long and dense coat of an Australian Shepherd, Collies have rough and short coats and their tails are plumed and longer. They are also not prone to develop heterochromia, which can be a good indicator when comparing the breeds. Hair color. When it comes to hair color, the Border Collie comes in a variety of hues that set them apart from an Australian Shepherd. Here are some of the colors of both breeds. Border Collie. Black. Blue. Brindle. Gold. Lilac. Red. Sable. Or a combination of two colors. Black and white. Blue and white. Red and white. Blue Merle. Blue Merle and white. Red Merle. Sable Merle. Saddleback Sable. White Tick. Australian Shepherd. Only four colors are available, namely black, red, blue merle, and red merle. Size. There is not much to go on when comparing a Border Collie and an Australian Shepherd when it comes to size, but there are some minor differences. Both are medium-sized dogs, but the Border Collie has a leaner and compact look, while the Australian Shepherd has a muscular, hardy build. Both have similar heights ranging from 18 to 23 inches, but their main difference is their weight. An Australian Shepherd adult male can weigh from 55 to 70 pounds or 25 to 32 kilos, while an adult female can weigh from 35 to 55 pounds or 16 to 25 kilos. An adult Border Collie male can weigh from 30 to 44 pounds or 14 to 20 kilos, while an adult female can weigh from 26 to 41 pounds or 12 to 19 kilos, much lighter than an Australian Shepherd. Grooming. Both dogs are prone to get dirty and may require a bath every now and then. If you own a Border Collie or an Australian Shepherd as a pet and not as a herding dog, both dogs may require a bath every month to keep them in their best form. If you live in a tropical region, however, these dogs may need a bath every 2 weeks. Regardless, frequent bathing may damage the skin and lessen the natural oils used by their coats. As an alternative, doggy wipes or dry shampoo can be used to keep them fresh in between bathing sessions. Border Collies require less attention compared to Australian Shepherds in terms of grooming due to their rough coats. Brushing these dogs twice or thrice a week is a good way to keep their coats in top condition. Nail trimming can also be done together with toothbrushing to keep them nice and clean. Herding dogs are prone to ticks or other parasites such as fleas. Ticks are nasty blood suckers that carry numerous bacteria known as blood parasites that can cause life-threatening diseases to dogs. These include Borrelia, which causes Lyme disease, and Babesia, which causes canine babesiosis. Fleas are also nasty blood suckers that can cause tremendous itching to your dogs. In response, dogs tend to scratch or nibble their skin to ease the itch. If your dog accidentally ingests a flea through nibbling, your dog may be infected with tapeworms, since fleas carry tapeworm larvae inside their bodies. Always consult your veterinarian when it comes to preventive treatment against these parasites. Temperament. Both the Australian Shepherd and Border Collie are intelligent dogs, but there is not much difference in terms of their personalities. Both dogs have innate herding instincts, so if you do not have any sheep or cattle that need herding, you, your kids, or anything that moves will most likely be herded by these dogs. That's why these dogs may not be ideal for families with toddlers. Despite this, these dogs are very affectionate and can be very dedicated to their tasks. Australian Shepherds are more easygoing than Border Collies in terms of completing tasks, but both dogs are energetic and protective of their flocks and families. Because of this, a lot of physical and mental stimulation must be given to these dogs together with proper socialization at such a young age. Otherwise, they may get into trouble later on in their lives. Before deciding to get a Border Collie or an Australian Shepherd, it's better to do some research first about their personalities and needs, since these dogs may not fit your lifestyle. Herding style. We go now to the main highlight of this video, and that is the herding style of these dogs. The Border Collie and Australian Shepherd are both great herding dogs, but they differ in herding style. Here are the main differences. Australian Shepherd. Animal driver. Can help animals move from one place to another. Communicates through movement. Loose-eyed or gives less eye contact. Herds the animals from the flank or behind to get them into position. Barks to keep animals in check. Border Collie. Gathering dog. Assembles the herd in one place. Strong-eyed or communicates through eye contact. Has a slinking movement. Rarely barks. Health. Like other medium or large-sized dog breeds, both dogs are susceptible to elbow and hip dysplasia, which are genetic diseases that cause the hip or elbow joints to improperly develop, leading to arthritis. This often leads to lethargy, limping, or straight-up lameness. These dogs are also prone to eye problems, particularly progressive retinal atrophy or PRA. PRA is a collection of degenerative diseases that usually affect the photoreceptor cells of the retina. Atrophy is defined as the partial or total wasting of a certain body part, and with PRA, the cells will slowly deteriorate as time progresses, which could lead to the blindness of the dog affected by the disease. Both dogs are also sensitive to certain drugs. A prime example of this is ivermectin, a common dewormer used in pets and livestock animals. Before giving any form of medication to your dogs, always consult your veterinarian to keep your dogs from harm. And there you have it, guys! This wraps up Border Collie versus Australian Shepherd differences. Which is better? Let us know what you think in the comments below. We hope that this video cleared some things up about these two awesome breeds. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and check out our playlist of other dog versus dog videos you won't want to miss. If you're looking into getting a dog or already have one, training is the most important thing you can do as a good responsible dog owner to make sure you end up with a well-behaved member of the family that you can enjoy. You can start training your dog today with the airplane game for free. Play with your dog 10 to 15 minutes per day to increase your dog's focus and obedience. Download link is in the description box below this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.